Hi students, today we are going to learn the next compartment of the digestive system in humans. Next compartment is the next compartment, the food pipe and the food pipe or the esophagus. Food pipe or esophagus. In the last class, we learn about the human digestive system. The human digestive system consists of first of all, we eat the food through our mouth. Inside the mouth, we can see there are teeth, tongue. Then different types of glands are present. Salivary gland secretes saliva. And in our tongue, there are different taste buds are present. Sweet, salty, bitter and sour. Sweet, salty, sour and bitter. Okay. Then we use teeth for cutting or bite or grinding the food items that we eat. Then these, where do the food items go? We swallow or we eat or we chew. Yes, the food items that we eat go to our stomach. Then after go to stomach, the food item goes to the food pipe or the esophagus. Then the food pipe or esophagus. Then the food pipe runs along the neck and the chest. The food pipe runs along the neck. After neck, it runs along the chest. Neck and chest. Once again, another compartment of human digestive system is the food pipe or esophagus. The food pipe, the food that we swallow or that we eat or that we chew passes into the food pipe. Then the food pipe runs along the neck and the chest. The food pipe is a tube-like structure which connects the mouth to the stomach. The food pipe runs along neck and chest. Okay, then the food pipe carries slightly digested food. We know that the food that we eat digested in our stomach. The food that we eat goes into the stomach. Then the digestion takes place inside our stomach. First, the food that we eat goes to the food pipe. That food is slightly digested food. So the food pipe carries the slightly digested food. From mouth to the stomach. Once again, the swallowed food passes into the food pipe. The food that we eat passes into the food pipe and it runs. The food pipe runs along the neck and chest. The food pipe runs along the neck and chest. Then it carries, the food pipe carries slightly digested food, slightly digested food, slightly digested food. The food pipe carries slightly digested food from where? From mouth to stomach. From mouth to stomach. Mouth to stomach. Mouth to stomach. The food pipe carries slightly digested food from where? Mouth to stomach. Mouth to stomach. Then, sometimes our stomach cannot accept food items. Cannot accept food items. It push upward from our stomach. At that time, we feel vomiting. At that time, we feel vomiting. At that time, we feel vomiting. Now, how food moves from? Moves in the opposite direction during vomiting. Do you know how food moves in the opposite direction during vomiting? We know that we vomit through our mouth. We eat food through food into the mouth. In the downward direction, vomiting takes place in the upward direction. How it will takes place? How it will takes place? Food is pushed downward by a. The food is pushed downward by a wave-like movement produced by the bowl of food pipe. The food is pushed downward. Food is pushed downward by a wave-like movement produced by the food pipe. As a result of alternate contraction and relaxation, this takes place. This movement of the food pipe is called peristalsis. This movement of food pipe is called peristalsis. Once again, the food pipe. How vomiting is takes place? How vomiting? During vomiting, the food moves in the opposite direction. How the food moves in the opposite direction? How the food moves in the opposite? First of all, what do you mean by peristalsis? The food push downward. The food push downward. If we eat food, the eaten food is pushed downward by a wave-like movement produced by the wall of food pipe. As a result, relaxation and contraction is occurred. Relaxation and contraction is occurred in the food pipe. This movement is called a peristalsis. This movement is called a peristalsis. All of you understood? What do you mean by peristalsis? And the food is pushed downward by a wave-like movement produced by the wall of food pipe. As a result, the contraction and relaxation like movement is occurred. So this type of movement is called peristalsis. Then the chewed food that enters the esophagus. First of all, the food that we eat goes to the food pipe or the esophagus, that enters the esophagus from mouth and is passed down to stomach is called bolus. First of all, we eat food into the mouth, through the mouth. Then that food goes down and passed down into the stomach is called bolus. Then sometimes food is not accepted our stomach. We know that sometimes food is not accepted our stomach. So we feel vomited out. Why? Because the food moves in the opposite direction. Because the food moves in the opposite direction, that is from the stomach to the mouth, from the stomach to the mouth, by a movement is called antiperistaltic movement. By antiperistaltic movement, antiperistaltic movement. Antiperistaltic movement. Once again, how is vomiting takes place? How is vomiting takes place? Sometimes the food is not. Sometimes food is not accepted by our stomach and is vomited out because the food moves in the opposite direction. That the food moves in the opposite direction. That is from the stomach to the mouth by antiperistaltic movement. By antiperistaltic movement. Okay, all of you understood what is peristalsis, what is bolus, how vomiting is takes place, how vomiting is takes place. Okay, once again, what is peristalsis? Peristalsis means the food is pushed downward by a movement produced, wave-like movement produced by the wall of food pipe. As a result of the movement, relaxation and contraction is occurred, so that is called peristalsis. Then what do you mean by bolus? Bolus means the chewed food that we eat goes through esophagus from mouth, then it passes into the stomach. It is called a bolus. Then what is antiperistaltic movement? Sometimes the food does not accept it by our stomach. The food that we eat goes in the opposite direction. That goes in the opposite direction. That is from the stomach to the mouth by antiperistaltic movement. Then next one, windpipe. In our elementary canal, in the food pipe and windpipe is present. Food pipe and windpipe is present. The food in the food pipe, food is passes into the food pipe and. Next one, windpipe. Next one is windpipe. Windpipe carries air. Windpipe carries air. Windpipe. It carries air. It carries air. It carries air from nostril to our lungs. From nostrils to our lungs. Our lungs. Windpipe. Windpipe carries air from nostrils to our lungs. Windpipe carries air from nostrils to our lungs. Then windpipe and food pipe are adjacent to each other in the elementary canal. Windpipe and food pipe. Windpipe and food pipe. Windpipe and food pipe are adjacent to each other. Windpipe and food pipe are adjacent to each other. The food pipe carries the food and the windpipe carries air from nostrils to our lungs. Food pipe carries food from mouth to stomach. Windpipe carries air from nostrils to our lungs. And these two pipes, the wood pipe and the food pipe and the windpipe adjacent to each other. The food pipe and the windpipe are adjacent to each other. Then air and food. In these two pipes, air and food are passes. The air and food share a common passage in the throat. In our throat. Air and food share a common passage in our throat. The windpipe and food pipe are adjacent to each other, so the air and food share a common passage. In our throat. throat. Then when we swallow food, when we swallow food, the food passes through the food pipe. When we swallow food, the food passes through the food pipe. Then at that time the windpipe is closed. At that time when we swallow food, the food is passes through the food pipe. At that time the windpipe is closed. The windpipe is closed when we swallow food. When we swallow food, food pipe is open. Food pipe is open. Windpipe is closed. Windpipe is closed. Windpipe is closed. Then closed by a flap like valve. Closed. Windpipe is closed by a flap like valve. Flap like valve. Once again, when we swallow food, the food pipe is open. The swallowing food is passes through the food pipe. At that time, the windpipe is closed by a flap like valve. Flap like valve. During eating, if we laugh or speak, the food is enter into the windpipe. The food enter into the windpipe. At that time the valve is open and the food enter into the windpipe. During that time we feel hiccups. Then we feel coughing. Through coughing, the food clear from the windpipe. Once again, the windpipe and the food pipe are adjacent to each other. Through windpipe carries air from nostril to our lungs. The food pipe carries the swallowed food from mouth to our stomach. They are adjacent to each other. So air and food share a common passage in our throat. When we swallow the food through our food pipe, at that time the windpipe is closed by a flap like a valve. During eating, if we laugh or talk to someone, the food is enter into the windpipe and we feel hiccups. That coughing clearing the food particles enter into the windpipe. Through coughing. Okay, all of you understood how hiccups are occurred. So next topic is stomach. Next part of the elementary canal, or the next compartment of the elementary canal is stomach in our human digestive system. The stomach was first discovered by an American doctor, William Newman. William Newman. In 1922, William Newman in 1922 in 1922 Accidentally, in the man named Alexis St. Martin. Alexis St. Martin. Who was discovered the stomach? The stomach was discovered by an American doctor, William Buman in 1922 by accidentally. Accidentally in the man named Alexis St. Martin. Then the stomach is a thick walled bag-like structure. Stomach is a thick walled bag-like structure which is present. The stomach is present on the left side of the abdomen. Then its shape is like a flattened U. And it is the widest part of the alimentary canal. Widest part of the alimentary canal. Once again, we learned about stomach. The stomach is discovered by an American doctor, William Buman. In 1922, the man named Alexis St. Martin. And then the stomach is a thick walled bag-like structure. The stomach is a thick walled bag-like structure and is present on the left side of the abdomen. The stomach is present on the left side of the abdomen. Then the shape of the stomach is like a flattened U shape. And the stomach is the widest part of the alimentary canal. All of you understood? Once again, about stomach. Who discovered the stomach? The stomach is discovered by an American doctor, William Buman, in 1922, accidentally in the man named Alexis St. Martin. The stomach is a thick walled bag-like structure. And it is present on the left side of the abdomen. And its shape is like a flattened U shape. And it is the widest. The stomach is the widest part of the alimentary canal. Then, in our stomach, the semi-digested food enters into our stomach. We learn about the which compartment of the alimentary canal? About the stomach. Then, the partially digested food enters into the stomach. where further digestion takes place. The partially digested food, partially digested food, partially digested food, partially digested food enters into the stomach, where further digestion takes place. Where further digestion takes place. Then the moving of food from the mouth into the stomach takes place in 3 hours. The moving of food from the mouth to the stomach, is taking 3 hours. For the movement of food into stomach takes place in 3 hours. First of all, the food is break down. Into smaller pieces. The food breaks down into smaller pieces. Then, and forms smaller pieces and forms a semi-solid paste. Secretes mucus, hydrochloric acid, and digestive juices or enzymes. The moving of food from the mouth into the stomach takes 3 hours. Takes place for 3 hours. First of all, the partially digested food entering into the stomach, it breaks down into smaller pieces and then form a semi-solid paste. Then in the inner lining of the stomach, secretes, mucus, hydrochloric acid, digestive juices and enzymes. Then the function of mucus, is to protect the inner lining of the stomach from the action of hydrochloric acid. Once again, the moving of food from mouth to stomach takes place in 3 hours. First of all, the partially digested food breaks down into smaller pieces and forms semi-solid paste. The inner lining of the stomach secretes mucus, hydrochloric acid, digestive juices and enzymes. The mucus helps the mucus helps the stomach, the mucus helps the inner lining of the stomach from the action of hydrochloric acid. Mucus helps the inner lining of stomach from the action of hydrochloric acid. From the action of hydrochloric acid. From the action of the mucus helps the inner lining of stomach from the action of hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid kills the bacteria, kills the harmful bacteria present in the food and also it helps in the digestion of proteins in the stomach. Once again, it is a function of hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid helps to kill the harmful bacteria present in the partially digested food, and also it helps for the digestion of proteins in the stomach. Once again, the hydrochloric acid, the HCl kills bacteria present in bacteria present in the food. Then it also helps, the hydrochloric acid also helps in the digestion of protein in the stomach. Then the partially digested food from the stomach moves from the stomach to small intestine. At last, the partially digested food moves from stomach to small intestine. Once again about stomach. The stomach is discovered by an American doctor, William Bowman. It is a thick walled bag-like structure present on the left side of the abdomen. Its shape is like a flattened U, and it is the widest part of the alimentary canal. The semi-digested food pass from the stomach where further digestion takes place. Then the moving of food from the mouth to the stomach takes place in 3 hours. Then then first of all the partially digested food breaks down into small pieces and forms a semi solid paste. The inner lining of the stomach produces or secretes mucus, hydrochloric acid and digestive juices. The mucus protects the inner lining of the stomach from the action of hydrochloric acid. The hydrochloric acid helps to kill the bacteria present in the food and also it helps in the digestion of proteins in the stomach. Then the partially digested food goes from the stomach to small intestine. All of you understood? In the class we learned about the food pipe or esophagus and about the stomach. So I write two questions here. First question, who discovered the stomach? Then second question, draw the movement of the food in the esophagus. Draw the movement of food. Draw the movement of food in the esophagus of the alimentary canal. First question, who discovered the stomach? William Newman. Draw the movement of food in the esophagus of the alimentary canal. First of the picture is given in your textbook. Then all of you find and draw the movement of food in the esophagus of the alimentary canal. Okay, then after drawing or answering these two questions, take a photo and send it to me. Okay, all of you understood? Thank you.